In this lesson, we're going to talk about fill in the blank prompting. So what this is this format allows the user to focus on the specific aspect of a sentence or idea that at the end of the day is going to encourage deeper thinking because you're actually going to be filling out information. So additionally, this is a flexible tool for learning and communication because of the format that ChatGPT is going to output its content in. So our formula is, you are an expert at creating prompts that generate the most concise and resourceful responses. What additional bullet point details can I add to the following prompt to improve the output? My prompt is, boom, your prompt. And then the part two of this prompt is, okay, great. Now turn these bullet points into a fill in the blank format, which I can put my information into. So let's take one of these examples. I have $100,000 in savings. What should I invest in? So let's go over to ChatGPT and do this prompt. So here we have our prompt, and I'm gonna go ahead and paste in our first example. So we have, what additional bullet points can I add to the following prompt to improve my output? My prompt is, I have $100,000 in savings, what should I invest in? Now we have a very in-depth bullet point list of 10 things to focus on to get really clear on our answer. Now what I wanna do is put in the second part of our prompt formula, which is, great, now turn these bullet points into a fill in the blank format, which I can put my information into. This is gonna make the answers a lot more intuitive, or just really make the ability for me to complete this task and fill in this information in a lot more intuitive way. So my investment goal is blank. My risk tolerance is blank. My investment timeline is blank. My knowledge of investing is this, my current tax situation is this, and it even gives an example of what direction to go into. So this is a lot more intuitive to work with ChatGPT on versus this type of format. So it's a pretty cool prompt framework to use. Now let's go on to our next prompt framework in the following lesson.